Hey guys, what's going on? It's Stephen W. 1323, and welcome back to another Do It For Dale Season 2, Race 13. We are going on to Dover. Let's take a look at the point standings real quick. That's not the point standings, it's the paint scheme. Excuse me. Real quick, after our recap of last race, we finished second, are going for four ends, but now with that, we are only 6 points away from Bobby Labonte from taking the points lead. Our stats go, we've got 4 wins, 6 top 5s, and 8 top 10s. Average start of 9th, average finish 11.3. You know, it's to compare it to last year, I don't know how well it's going. It might be improving, it might not be. But either way, we're still doing it for Dale. I appreciate you for being here. Give this video a thumbs up, and now let's go to Dover. Alrighty, here we come, man. We have a good car. I'm not gonna lie. I took 2 laps around here. I don't think I was the fastest, but I was up there. That one took off really tight into that turn for some reason. Let's see how we're gonna do in the 3 and 4. I think we got a really good car. I know I say that a lot, but like, look at the way this thing is just sticking here in Dover. Second. Oh my goodness, can we get the pole? If not, we'll take second. Coming down. All right. Trying to do our best, do everything but get the pull off the line. Oh, second. Dang it. Oh, by 1/1000th of a second. You're kidding me. Oh, that hurt. That hurt. Oh, that still hurts my soul.
Welcome to Delaware for the running of the MBNA Armed Forces Family 400 at Dover International Speedway. This is a tough track, both physically and mentally. What is it the drivers struggle with so much here, Barney?
Well, the name Monster Mile does say it all. It takes total concentration each and every lap. You'll see guys tagging the wall out of turn 2 and 4 all race long, and let me tell you, they'll feel it tomorrow morning.
Dale Earnhardt will try for another top five finish in this one.
You know, there are drivers in this NASCAR Winston Cup Series who don't have a single win for their whole career, and that guy won 2 in a row like it was nothing. I'm telling you, he's got to be a favorite for the championship this year.
Matt Kenseth got his start in NASCAR Winston Cup here at Dover in 1998, filling in for Bill Elliott in a one-race deal.
He had quite a day, too. He caught the eye of a bunch of folks with a sixth-place finish. Here you are, first time in a cup race, driving a Hall of Famer's car, and you finish sixth. That's amazing.
Forgot about that.
Robbie Gordon finds himself in a bit of a slump.
And trust me, it hasn't been for the lack of effort. Those guys have been working hard all season. Maybe they can right the ship with a good finish here.
It's so beautiful seeing the 3 and the 2 on the front row. Here we go. Green flag is out. Jeff Gordon's arrival right now. He's at 60, so he will try to wreck us. But apparently we have the restart gear in her as I drive it down onto the apron. and just take the lead away from Rusty Wallace. The question now is, what's going to happen between Jeff and I? Is he going to try and wreck me here? Ooh, we're going to get the run out of the corner, I think. Oh, he's going to wreck us. Oh, my God. No way. I guess you're getting a new race, guys. Wow. We're coming for you, Jeff. Wow, that sucked. Oh, they didn't even give us an outro or nothing? Okay. Well, let's take a look. Well, Jerry Nadeau won the race somehow. Let's take a look at the off-race results. Jerry Nadeau won the race, followed by Matt Kenseth, Tony Stewart, Rusty Wallace, Ricky Craven led 10 laps. Jimmy Johnson, Elliott Sadler, Jeremy Mayfield, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and Dale Jarrett rounds out your top 10. Well, points leader finished 15th. Gordon got 23rd somehow. And we didn't even get a replay of the wreck or nothing. Man, we were the only car out of that wreck. That's crazy. 21 lane changes in a Dover race. All right, let's go to the next race, I guess. Wow, the point standing shook up a whole bit. Matt Kenseth's now the points leader, followed by Bobby Labonte, Tony Stewart, Rusty Wallace, Jimmy Johnson, Newman. We dropped all the way to 7th. Sterling Marlin and Dale Jarrett 9th. Jeff Gordon rounds out the top 10. Wow, that one hurt really, really bad. Awards, no one got awards, of course. We still have the lap champion by almost 100. So let's go to Pocono, I guess, because that's where we're heading. Yeah, the tricky triangle. All right, let's try this again. Take two, huh? All right, we had another great car in qualifying. And now it's just time to see if we can transfer it into the race. I think this is going to be a good car. Here, it's just, I changed my gearing just a little bit. Just so going into certain straightaways, I don't come anywhere close to blowing the motor. That was a great tunnel turn right there. We needed it. I'm trying to put this thing back on the pole and get, you know, some sort of redemption. If we see Jeff Gordon, I don't care where. If it's in this race, we're dumping him. But Jeff Gordon, You just have a rivalry started, my friend. That was 9th off the first lap. We ran so much better on our second lap in practice, so I think that's what we're going to do here. As long as I don't lose it. Ooh, we got a little loose there. I think that might have cost us a little bit. We'll see if we can make it up in the tunnel turn. Ah, we got loose in the tunnel turn, too, so I don't know if we're going to get anywhere better than 9th. If we do, it's not going to be by much. Ooh, look at that. Nice exit out of, yes, turn 3, because what turn 4 here at Pocono? Down to the line, it is definitely not better. We'll take a 10th starting spot, though. Let's hopefully we can finish a little better than we did last race.
MRN is live in Pennsylvania today at the Pocono Raceway for the Pocono 500. This track produces some of the fastest racing of the year, but it also presents some special challenges to the drivers.
Well, this is one of NASCAR's toughest tracks, especially for the crews who set up these race cars. Nothing is the same in any aspect of this racetrack. 3 totally different corners, 3 straightaways of different lengths. It's enough to drive a crew chief crazy.
Sterling Marlin, who's currently in the top 10 in points, will try to reach that next step, the top 5.
He's been working hard this season, and it is paying off so far. He'll need a good finish in this one to gain some spots.
Dale Earnhardt will try to use this race to gain a couple spots in the points.
Yeah, he needs to focus on this race. A poor finish can quickly bounce you out of the top 10, but a win can gain you several positions.
I blame Jeff Gordon.
The top 5. We'll see what happens.
Kevin Harvick accomplished an incredible feat in 2001. He won the Busch Series Championship while competing full-time on the Winston Cup Circuit.
To race all those miles and be as good as he was is simply amazing. I'm sure the extra track time helped him, but you just get tired racing like that every weekend.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Here we go at the tricky triangle. Of course, we got rivals in front of us, but that's okay. Green flag is out. We are going to try to do our best. We got Mikey in front of us. Hi, Mikey. How you been? It's been a minute since we've seen you. Probably would have saw you in the last race if, you know, all that stuff didn't happen. Oop. Sorry, Mark. Didn't mean to do that. Yeah, he's a little mad, but it's okay. So now, I think we do have a really good car. It's just going to be a matter of picking the right lines and going with it, making the right adjustments. It's 20 lap. Ooh, Mark's really not going to like me now. Sorry, Mark. 20 lap race. I think we'll be okay. I just got to focus on what I'm doing and not the other cars around me. You guys have also noticed I've gotten a lot better driving in the, was this third person, I guess? I don't know. Behind the car. We are catching up. We're going to have a hell of a run going into the turn one. Oh, shit. Sorry, Kurt. Junior's still mad at us, too. But it's okay. Already up to sixth after that amazing turn. Yeah, I'm sure that's probably not the way we should have done it, but mistakes were made. I'm, oop, just like that. Mistakes were made, but we're helping Junior apparently go to the front now, because he's mad at us. I guess the holiday's coming up here. We're coming up close to the new Daytona race, so 4th of July might be a little awkward. Ooh, we're going to get a run maybe on Bobby. Oop, nope, we're going to hit him in the boat. Oop, but we're going to take third barely. Oh my goodness, we almost, I swear if we would have wrecked, I would have probably thrown a controller. Ooh, look at this. Got the run off of turn three on the Lowe's and Home Depot, and here comes the Good Wrench Plus Chevrolet. On lap four in the third spot, look at him. Go for the lead. Ooh, it didn't stick. It stuck a little bit. All right, nice battle in here. Side by side for second. Tony Stewart's hi. What are we doing, Jimmy? Woof, he just slammed on his brakes here. We just nearly wrecked him into the tunnel turn. That was insane. Now he's going to hit us. Both Hendrick, all the Hendrick guys are going to hate us. That's probably the storyline here this season. Hendrick versus, I thought, no, if I was going to make that turn or not. I just want to draft him down so I don't get hit. He can block me all he wants. We're going to try and catch the leader. That was a bad entry into the turn. Bobby's going to be low on me, isn't he? No, yeah. Jimmy got the run there. He's pulling away slowly, but we're going to hit the wall. Now we're going to have a lot of damage to repair. It's going to cost us a lot of time on pit road unless we get a caution or something crazy. We caught Jimmy Johnson. And we're coming into turn three. There's a car blowing up. I don't think this is going to cause any troubles here. Wow! I saw him coming too. That's the worst part. Woof. Man, this car's gonna be real slow now after that. Probably. Just gonna let them all go by. Let this be how it is right now. Oh, what a race. Okay, of course, he hits me and he's mad at me. Some cars are pitting, it looks like. Already. Makes me think of what I'm going to do. I really have no idea yet. Oop. Make more rivals, I know that for sure. Oh, Tony had hit the wall there. Whoopsie. We're not even halfway on fuel, and that's the thing. People are pitting. That makes me question a lot of things right now about this race. All these guys are trying to make it. Or are these the guys who can't make it? Or this is just the fuel window? I have no idea. We'll find out here in a little bit. Maybe more cars will be pitting. Oh, I hate when those cars come off pit road like that. I have to check up. Then slow all my momentum down. Oof, this car does not want to turn anymore. Go ahead, Junior. Oh, come on. That's really going to mark more points against me. All right, we need to pit. I think I'm going to pit this lap. Honestly, it's halfway. We haven't even hit low fuel yet, so that's a good thing. It means we'll have plenty of fuels and more tires to go around. This car is just undrivable. As Dale Jarrett nearly tried to wreck me, it felt like. Here we come, though. We're going to be coming off turn three. Yeah, we're definitely coming down the pit road this time. Like, I can't even keep the car down low or nothing. Okay, cool. Everyone else has the same idea I do, apparently. Ooh, don't spin it, don't spin it, don't spin it, don't spin it, don't speed, don't speed, don't speed. Perfect. Let's go. Four tires, fuel. It's going to be 2 seconds of damage. It's going to stink. It's what we're going to do. Yeah, we're going to keep everything like that. Put some more pressure in there and hope that this will be a good pit stop and our team can hopefully do something and help us win this race. Darn, we didn't have any flappy parts. We have any flappable part problems. Who knows? We might have a great car and come back and get a great finish. We might not. This could be a risky mistake. Who knows? Here we come out of the thing. Go, go, go. Thank you. It was a great stop. Now it just all depends on all these cars here. If they've pitted or not, or if these are the back markers that have already pitted. And now I just have to make my way through the traffic. Or if they're going to have to pit again, who knows. Either way, we'll just see where everything cycles out here in just a little bit. I don't even know if everyone's pitted yet. Because remember, we didn't even hit low fuel when... That's going to be interesting right there. Whoopsie-daisy. Sorry about that, Sterling. Didn't mean to do that, but... Again, you guys check up so early in the tunnel turn. Man, this car's finally sticking, but not... Doesn't have the speed in it I want for some reason. Can't explain it. Leaders are pitting. Love to hear it. Well, it seems like of everything, we cycled out 13th. So we lost a lot of spots, but remember, we had to repair a lot of damage. So now from here, it's just gold go time. I don't think we can win it. I really don't. I think we can, if we get a caution before there's like two laps to go, maybe we have a chance. But if not, I at least want to finish where we started, and that was 9th. Yeah, Ricky, I block all the way down to the track too, if I ever you. Ooh, look at that run out of the turn. That was beautiful. 3 wide for 8th with 5 laps to go. How bad is this going to go? Oh, we actually made it out of there just fine. Perfect. Let's go. 9th, 8th. We're battling for 8th here. We really don't have much time to battle here with these guys if we at least want to try to get a top 5 or something. We just don't have the acceleration out of the turns like a lot of these cars do with their setups. And that's just the thing, but who knows? We got the speed for sure when it comes down to it. We just got to hold them off for a second. Who's that in front of us? Bill Elliott's in front of us, then Jeff Gordon. I'm not going to wreck Jeff because we're so far... from the leader, it's not even funny, and it would just end the race at that point, and I want to battle for a spot as we get a great run on Ricky Rudd past him for the 7th spot. Easy, buddy. That left front tire seen some action. Sweet moves past Jeff Gordon for the sixth spot with, what is that, three to go, coming to two to go here. Messed up that turn a little out a bit. There's a championship leader, Matt Kenseth. He's not having the race he needs to have. Ooh. I don't know why I just got loose on the straightaways, but I did. Yahtzee! That worked. Holy crap. We got a top five spot right now, and we're going to try and get just a few more. I don't think we can get really more, but we're going to pour our hearts out. We're going to run this car as hard as we can, as smart as we can, as we come to the white flag. If not, we at least got a top five. It's at least a good bounce back from Dover. White flag, juniors in front of us. They're all battling for the lead. Who knows? Maybe something crazy will happen between all three of them. That'd be funny as hell. Oop, messed that turn up big time. Oh, Jeff Gordon's going to get by me. Son of a bitch. So did Matt Kenseth. I didn't like to see that at all. Oh, fudge. All right, well, who knows? Maybe we can at least get one of them. I really thought we had it. God, I couldn't get the car out of the turn there. Or out of the wall there. Thought we at least had a top five car. We at least are going to get Matt Kenseth here. Ooh, I don't know why I'm going into this angle, but I am. Maybe we can get to Gordon here, wreck him for the top five. It doesn't look like it. Either way, solid top 10. Hopefully we gain some points. We gained some spots, so that's a good positive, right? I'll take it.
Lead changes were pretty scarce.
Yeah, there weren't too many battles up front for position. Those guys who ran in the top five were pretty dominant all race long.
Dale Earnhardt ended up in the top 10 at the end of the race.
Of course, all these teams want to win every race, but a top 10 finish is still a great accomplishment at the racetrack.
Dale Earnhardt had a run-in during the race with Jimmy Johnson.
I'm not sure how all this got started, but now that they have a little history on the track, it'll be something to watch in the weeks ahead.
We're out of time here at MRN. We hope you enjoyed today's race, and we'll see you next time.
What more can I say than mistakes were made? You know, I think we had a winning car, or at least a car to compete up there. Until we rear-ended Jimmy Johnson and helped him push his way to a victory here at Pocono. Second place goes to Tony Stewart, third Jr. Fourth, Ryan Newman. Fifth, Jeff Gordon. We got sixth. Seventh, Kenseth. Eighth, Ricky Rudd. Ninth, Sterling Marlin. And 10th rounds out Kurt Busch. And I think the only car to DNF was, what was that? David Green, he's the one that we, there was two DNFs, David Green and Jerry Nadeau. Hate to see it. Let's go see what these point standings look like. Wow, look at those point standings. It's now a 14-point lead over Matt Kenseth, Tony Stewart. And then there's Bobby Labonte. Jimmy Johnson's up here. Let's take a look at his stats, man. He's actually becoming 7-time. Look at that. He's got his second win. 5 top 5, 8 top 10s. Look at this guy. He's actually doing really good this year. He might be a championship contender. Isn't that crazy to think? Huh. Ryan Newman. Then us. We are in 613 back. Rusty 7th. Sterling's 8th. 9th is Jeff Gordon. Dale Jarrett rounds out our top 10. You know, that race wasn't our best, but, you know, I really thought we were going to have a good race coming off going to have a great race at Dover until Gordon wrecked us. We had the fastest lap of the race, so that's great to see. We didn't lead any laps, but hey, it is what it is. Jimmy Johnson's finally making his way up there. Love to see it. Love to see it. We're going on to Michigan, and honestly, the next time we record, I'm going to have an awesome story and a video coming soon about Michigan, my home track. And let me just put it to you this way. I'm going to get to go there for the very first time. And if this is your very first time watching us here on YouTube, I appreciate you so very much. Give us a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new. I can't say more. You guys rock. Thank you. But until next time, I'll see you.